Hi students, in this presentation I'll be talking about the fifth concept from module 4, which is about the network analytics. In the previous presentation I guess we could see the data analytics concept. So in this data analytics and network analytics there is a minute difference. So in the data analytics like we find the network patterns in the data which is generated by the endpoints. In the network analytics, so we can discover the patterns in the communication flows from the traffic perspective. That is the only difference. I repeat, in the data analytics like we can find the patterns with the data which is generated by the endpoints and end devices, but in this network analysis like the patterns will be found in the communication flow from the traffic perspective only. So that is the only concern here. That is the only concern. So there are different types of details which need to be analyzed. So network analytics will have the power to analyze the details of different types of communication patterns, like different types of protocols and how the correlation can happen among the network. Like they will define like what kind of procedures like can be suggested for the network problems to overcome and to go for the optimization, for the congestion, to avoid the congestion, for the malware attacks and all these things will be identified through this network analytics only. So just mainly we are observing here what are the capabilities, what is the capacity and what is the planning to work with the network. Suppose if I want to enhance a network, so I need to have a network analytics to scale the to scale and to provide the security after scaling the network. So complete the information will be detected through this network analytics. As I mentioned, like it will discover the complete patterns in the communication flow from the traffic perspective only. So to monitor the network infrastructure, like we need to follow certain standards, protocols, characteristics, then IP related traffic flows, and what we say, identification of source and destination, like address, like data, timing, volume, everything. All these things will support for this network analytics to discover the patterns and to handle the network traffic in an efficient way. So we know that the data will be collected and it may be in a known or unknown format. So by using the external network analytic tools, like we can fine-tune the collected data and we can go with formatting the data, and we can assign the security and likely like we can monitor the data which has been created. There are different types of benefits to go for this network analytics. Like we can go for monitoring the traffic and the flow collection from the network layer will be helpful for the for the monitoring process. This is only one thing. Yeah, let me just say there are different types of protocols, we know that. It is flexible. Also for the capacity planning and monitoring the traffic, like what is the security analysis. Also accountability, like what kind of network, I mean what kind of network that we are using, what are the routers that we use, what are the gateways, physically they are connected, what kind of services that we can extract, which is a VPN that we use, like how the deployment has taken place with the gateways connected to the IoT infrastructure. So what is this flow monitoring result, what kind of data we are analyzing. So what is this data mining and warehousing element will helping the user. So data warehousing and data mining means the flow of the data which is derived can be used for later retrieval and analysis for the supportive of this IoT infrastructures and applications. So all these were the different types of benefits of this flow analytics, network flow analytics. Wherein which here we can go for network management services like which I discussed, network traffic monitoring, flow collection and application traffic monitoring, and so on up to data warehousing and then data mining. So all these were the network management services. Okay, the next one, as I was showing from this network analytics, is flexible net flow architecture. This is one of the prime component here under this network analytics. Here in the name itself, it is there, flexible net flow architecture. So it is exactly developed by this Cisco Systems only. So it is most probably it is used for as usual, wide variety of networks with some set of specific protocols. So it is mainly used for with various characteristics or with various advantages which supports the network architecture. So the main functionalities of this flexible net flow architecture is it supports the network with more flexibility and scalability for enhancements, and the data aggregation which will take place at the edges. And also it will go for monitoring the large volume of data, and it will help us to generate the new information with the new information with the network behavior, and also enhance the network information with the security detection and user configurable information, like how the traffic can be identified and how it can be monitored with proper network behavior, and how we can focus towards the handling the traffic in a different perspective, how we can work with the convergence of multiple accounting technologies in accounting mechanism. All these things were the advantages of this flexible net flow architecture. So this is an architecture wherein which it supports any kind of network with different types of protocols like FENF and IETF and RFC 5102. All these are the example protocols which will be used for these networks. So through these networks we can work with these kind of advantages. So we can experience the flexibility, scalability, aggregation of the data flow and so on. So it will focus towards the multiple number of account technologies for the accounts mechanism. So let us see the examples further here. Okay, there are different types of components. I guess the components, there are different types of components. Like the first component is like FNF flow monitor. FNF flow monitor, so wherein which it describes the net flow cache or the information stored in cache. So in the name itself, it is the information stored in the cache. It contains the complete recording or complete definitions and the key fields and non-key fields. Key fields in the sense like what we say, the data which is used to create, to flow and to match the statement, that is the key field. Non-key field means the attributes and characteristics of that particular data flow within the particular cache. So this FNF flow monitor will contains the these kind of information. Also, as a part of this, it will contain the information about the net flow and also destination address of that particular collector, etc. So this is the role of this FNF flow monitor. It will mainly monitor the data stored in the cache. Right, it may have the record of all these characteristic features within the cache. Next one is about the flow record. So in the name itself, it is a flow record, collection of key and non-key flow with the field values, which is used to characterize the net flow cache. So what we are characterizing here, the data records will be characterizing based on the predefined procedure. Right, how they are defined, how the aggregated data flow was existed already, what is the common application that the data can be utilized. So there are two different methods again to access this net flow data, like using show commands, like I guess in the Unix also we would have seen command line interface. Using show commands, an application can use the data by using the reporting tool. And flexible, what we say, net flow export, like wherein which the information can be pushed or pulled from the cache as per the requirement. There are different types of exporters where they can pull the data from the corresponding rack where it is stored. Right, This is about the FNF flow record. Next one is about the flow export timers. So in the name itself, it is a flow export timers. Timers means based on some threshold and some reporting format, the collection of the data, the collection of the data will be exported and it will be reported to the server, exported and then reported to the server within a specific format. The type of the format, data format, and the collection of this data format from the server and reporting. So everything will be seen as a part of this flow export timers. So like here we are using some analytic tools with different types of traffic patterns. And like here we may see how the flow reporting format will be indicated based on the the collection of the data and the reporting of the data. So flow export timers based on some threshold, some flow information, the data will be exported, the data will be reported to particular server. Okay, so next one is about the flexible net flow, I guess next slide, flexible net flow multi-service IoT networks. So the name itself, it is there, multi-service IoT networks. It will be configured on the routers for the aggregate data connections. There may be different types of views where the servers may follow between the different networks in the cloud. And what exactly we are seeing is we configure the gateway or the corresponding nodes for the visibility of the data. So just like NetFlow, it's a multi-service IoT network. Where all the services following between the core network in the cloud will be experienced here, right? And there are still more challenges what we can see. That's all about the network analytics.